For years, young people being detained along our southern border have reported being sexually abused at the hands of both fellow detainees as well as U.S. guards. And even though things are getting worse, this behavior did not originate during the Trump administration, as everybody would like to say. As plenty of past leaders have completely ignored this problem. Farron Cousins from Trial Lawyer Magazine is with me now to talk about it. Farron, the numbers are staggering. 4,500 reports, allegations of sexual abuse. If you look at this story, though, I'm hearing the same response that we heard under Obama. Obama had the same problem. Yep. Bush before him had the same problem. And the argument is always that it's not the HHS employees, they're subcontractors in each state that are the problem. What is your take on this story?
That's kind of the same thing we hear about. You know, anytime there's bad things that the government does or bad things are happening for government employees is, oh, no, it's our private contractors. Mm. You know, it's the private prison guards. It's the private mercenaries over in Iraq, the private contractors ripping us off. And now HHS says the same thing here. And the common thread is these contractors that we're hiring to do these jobs, whether it is make sure detainees aren't getting raped or deliver goods overseas, it's always the private contractors that are no good.
Here's what happens, and we've seen it in every one of the stories you describe. If they're always looking, these contracts we're talking about are always giveaways. They're political giveaways.
Yep.
And so they say, at one hand, they want to say, well, we're not really responsible. It was, you know, some subcontractor. No, you are responsible because these are big gifts and big giveaways. People are making a lot of money. And if you can't hire people that are qualified to do it, you know, that's your problem. But right now, I got to tell you, this is a big problem. But I want to point out, this has been a big problem for a long time. And as much as we talk about about Trump doing wrong, Obama, Bush did the same thing here, and they had the same problem and was never addressed.
Right. We had children locked in cages during the Obama administration along the southern border. We cannot overlook that, and we cannot give them a pass. It's been going on for too long, and now we're finding out the extent of the abuse, and each story that comes out is worse than the one before. Yeah. This takes the cake.
Drug company executives were hauled before the Senate to explain why are they gouging American citizens on the cost of their medications, and it didn't go well for those executives. Finally. Finally, somebody starts asking these people, well, let me get this right. We got 2,000, 10,000, 20,000 percent markup on your drugs, and you're telling us it's because R&D, that's a lie, because these drugs have been on the market forever, and you're still raising the prices. You know what? This calls attention to both the corporate Republicans and the corporate Democrats. Because the corporate Democrats are as much of the problem as the corporate Republicans. Take it from there.
Well, and the reason they're as much of the problem is because Big Pharma tends to spread their money out almost evenly. Republicans get a little bit more, but it's statistically insignificant. So they bought both sides. But here's an interesting thing, because, yes, all of these executives said, well, R&D is so expensive. We spend a lot of money. There was not one single drug between the year 2010 and 2016 approved by the FDA that was not funded and developed without taxpayer money. Every drug from 2010 to 2016 that was approved.
Explain how that works. And universities, go ahead and talk about that.
You know, taxpayers, we fund the universities. The government itself hires out scientists to do this research. We have government-funded scientists. And every drug from 2010 to 2016 was paid for and developed with
taxpayer money.
And they're lying.
Here's the real numbers on it. 75% of the money that they're saying is actually for R&D, actually is for advertising.
Right.
It's all these ads that you see every 10 seconds on the air. That's where the money's going. And now what I love about this right now, first of all, I'm not optimistic that much will come out of it. This is all a show.
Yeah.
You know, this is a show. They're going to appear in front of these congressmen, and the Congress is going to ask them a few tough questions. And you're only going to have a couple of people like Ron Wyden who actually does anything about it. You're going to have Cory Booker's and the Feinsteins. You're going to have all those people that say, let's give them a break. They won't say that overtly, but that's what they'll do behind closed doors. Farron, thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.